Massive petrochemical plant. It had seemed a wildly uneven battle. On one side, Sinopec, China's largest oil company, and Kuwait Petroleum, one of the world's largest oil companies. On the other side, well, a few professors, students, and citizen activists. Zhou Yongzhang is a professor at Zhongshan University. He and his students are visiting Nansha, recalling their fight to protect it.
广东省政府跟科威特那边有个谈判，谈就是内容大概就是说，科威特可以在我们广东省内啊，可以投资一个比较大的项目。
The project was to cover 8 square kilometers, and the investment was $9 billion, the largest of its kind in China.
广州当时有压力，当时就觉得好像有国内有些大城市，很多城市在紧追那个广州的 GDP， 比如天津，追得很紧，所以当时有这样的考虑，就选择了广州。
After the project was announced, some began to protest. Few took them seriously. Professor Zhou, a member of China's National Advisory Body, was one of the earliest to object. Making his case, he asked the government to relocate the plant.
这里是广州的上风口，石化它都是有排放有毒气体的，污染性气体的，它就会往广州方向飘。另外，这个地方呢跟香港也很近，这里再过去一点就是海边，海边对面就是香港，所以香港也很关注这个事情。One
minister told me that in the showdown between growth and pollution, growth must almost always win. The government, he said, must improve the economic lives of China's masses. And if some rich city folk would have to endure more pollution, so be it. After a protracted battle, all parties agreed to move the project out of Nansha. It was a shocking, massive win for environmentalists.
假如我们是建了这个石化基地的话，所有这些实际上是不存在的了。应该说，对南沙将来的一个重新定位和发展了，应该是非常有帮助、非常有好处的。Nansha
is not an isolated case. There are now many examples in China where environmental activists have successfully stopped government plans. Moreover, the Chinese government itself is actively readjusting its industrial structure to balance economic development and environmental protection.
所以中国应该说还是这种发展，就是从我们一般的工业文明往生态文明的跨越，我们还是看到了这一点。
China, the largest population on Earth, has come to a historical turning point. China must transform its economic model. It must create more profitable enterprises which can pay workers higher wages. And it must enable a financial system which can support the country's continent-size economy. At the same time, China must increase energy efficiency, balance economic growth with environmental protection, and surely rebalance the dangerous imbalances in society. China's new leaders know that they face the challenge of continuing to improve the lives of the Chinese people. The Chinese people know it too.
walk together, they can discover. Okay, just walk a little bit.